Hi, my name is Patrick Fowler with Alaska Department of Fish and Game, and I'm here today to talk to you about requirements for personal use in sport shellfish pots in Southeast Alaska. There are a variety of makes and manufacturers of pots out there. You can even use homemade pots, but your pots need to meet these couple of criteria that we're going to talk about today to be legal in the state of Alaska. All pots must meet a biodegradable escape mechanism and have a properly marked buoy. In addition to that, crab pots need appropriately sized escape rings, and shrimp pots need to meet size requirements. Like we mentioned, a biodegradable escape mechanism is required in all shellfish pots. This escape mechanism is designed to degrade over time, releasing any organisms that are trapped in your pot if it were to ever become lost or unretrievable. Now, the way this mechanism is constructed depends on the type of construction of your pot. We have particular regulations for non-rigid mesh, like this shrimp pot, and rigid mesh, like this Dungeness pot. So rigid mesh pots, these must incorporate a panel which will fall away from the pot, exposing an opening that will allow shellfish to escape the pot if necessary. Now, this panel can be attached only with 30 thread count untreated cotton twine, one loop in each corner, and each loop can only have one knot. Now, the opening that the panel exposes must be sized appropriately to the type of species that you're fishing for. For Dungeness, this is a 10-inch by 6-inch opening. For King and Tanner, a 12-inch by 8-inch opening. And if you have a rigid mesh shrimp pot, it's a 4-inch by 4-inch opening. Now, this opening must be within 6 inches of the bottom of the pot and parallel to it. Okay, now let's talk about non-rigid mesh pots. These are the types of pots with netting surrounding a metal frame. To satisfy your biodegradable escape mechanism requirements for this type of pot, the only thing we need to do is incorporate an opening laced with 100% untreated 30 count cotton twine. Now, this opening, the size requirements vary depending on what type of pot this is. This particular pot is a shrimp pot, which has a requirement of a 6-inch opening. Dungeness, King, and Tanner crab pots all require an 18-inch opening. In addition to that size of the opening has to be within 6 inches of the bottom of the pot and parallel to it. The cotton twine can only be knotted at each end, not in the middle. And this cotton twine cannot be secured or looped around the metal bars and supporting structures of the pot. When fishing with Dungeness pots, you have one other alternative that you can use to meet the biodegradable escape mechanism requirement. And that's using a 60 thread count cotton twine incorporated in a single loop within your pot lid tie down. That, when degrades, allows your pot lid to be unsecured. The one other requirement that all shellfish pots in Alaska must meet is to have a properly marked buoy with the angler's first initial, last name, address, and AK numbers or name of the boat that's pulling the pot. In addition to your biodegradable escape mechanism and buoy marking requirements, crab pots must have escape rings. These escape rings allow undersized crab to escape before the pot is even brought up. Now, each crab pot must have two escape rings on opposite sides. And for Dungeness pots specifically, the crab escape rings must be on the upper half of the vertical plane. The size of the escape ring varies depending on the species being targeted. With Dungeness crab, the inside diameter needs to be 4 3/8 inch. For Tanner crab, 4 3/4 inch. And for King crab, 6 1/4 inch. Now, not all pots come equipped with the properly sized rings. You can purchase these aftermarket rings and install them yourself using zip ties or stainless steel wire. Finally, shrimp pots must conform to specific requirements. They may not have more than 4 tunnel-eye openings, and each of these openings may not exceed 15 inches in perimeter. In addition to that, the bottom perimeter of your shrimp pot cannot exceed 153 inches, and the total volume of your pot cannot exceed 25 cubic feet. As an example, this pot is about 3.5 cubic feet, and the bed of this pickup truck is about 60 cubic feet. All of the requirements that we've talked about today are outlined in the Southeast Alaska Sport Fish Regulation Summary, and we also have a pamphlet to help guide anglers through this process. Both of these materials are available at your local fish and game office, where I'd encourage you to call or come in with your pots and have the local staff help you make your pots legal.